Key to healthy hair is good shampoo and following a healthy hair care routine. In this video, I'll be showing you all to make shampoo that is 100% herbal without any harmful chemicals. Herbal shampoos works best because it gives you the essential natural nutrients without harming your hair. Unlike chemical shampoos, it is free from chemicals like sulfate, parabens and other additives. Herbal shampoo is an excellent way to keep your hair healthy, shiny and lustrous without any side effects when used regularly. I'll be sharing with you all a wonderful tip to store this shampoo for more than 6 months, so stay tuned to watch. Before I begin with the video, I would like to encourage you with a verse from the Holy Bible from Philippians 4:6. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present your request to God. My dear friends, God knows exactly what's going on in your life. He is always watching over you, waiting to help you. Whatever help you need, no matter how insignificant, you can simply ask, and the God who created the heavens and set the stars in place will hold you up. Isn't that amazing? Alright, now without further ado, let's get started with our video. Let's take a look at these ancient ingredients which is used to make herbal shampoo. First of all, we need shikakai, then amla, that is Indian gooseberries, and rita, it is also called soap nuts. These three are the classic ingredients to make any herbal shampoo. In addition to this, we can use other ingredients and herbs as required. We will also be adding fenugreek seeds to make this shampoo. Here I've taken 1 cup of shikakai, 1 cup of amla and 1 cup of rita. That's roughly 100 grams each. If you want your shampoo to lather more, you can use 1.5 cups of rita, that is soap nuts. In Ayurveda, shikakai is also called as fruit for your hair. It is an excellent cleanser and doesn't strip natural oils from your hair and scalp. It maintains the pH balance of your hair and it promotes hair growth, strengthens your hair roots and produces lengthy and beautiful hair. Amla, also known as the Indian gooseberry, is rich in antioxidants. It's been used for over 3000 years for a variety of health benefits. Amla contains the highest level of vitamin C on planet Earth. It's a great hair conditioner. It's a superfood for your hair as it treats dandruff, strengthens your hair and promotes new hair growth. Rita, known as soap nuts, is used as a key ingredient in natural hair washes for gently cleansing the hair and scalp. It has the natural conditioning properties that makes your hair healthy and shiny when used regularly. Rita is rich in anti-inflammatory properties, so it is effective for scalp. And lastly, fenugreek seeds. These seeds also help in promoting hair growth, strengthening hair follicles and thereby preventing hair fall. It also helps in moisturizing and bringing back bounce to your hair. Now I'll add some water to rinse out any impurities and dirts. Discard this water. To this add clean water near about 2 liters. Add 3 teaspoons of fenugreek seeds and give it a good mix. Cover it and leave this to soak overnight or up to 8 hours. Next morning it has been soaked well and you can see the rich brown color. Instead of open pot cooking, I'll add this to a cooker for quick and easy process. You can already see the lather. I'll pressure cook this for about 3 or 4 whistles. Now it's done, switch off the flame and let it cool down. As you can see, the mixture has been cooked well and it mashes up easily. Use a strainer to strain the mixture. We'll keep this aside. You can remove the seeds from soap nuts if required. Now squash the ingredients to pulp. If you wish, you can use hand gloves to do this process. Here, instead of adding extra plain water, use the same concoction to squash the mixture well so that your shampoo will have nice thick consistency and not watery. You will notice a lot of froth is being produced during this process. This is when you know that your shampoo has acquired all the goodness of these beautiful ingredients. To this collected residue, I'm adding some more concoction and mixing it well. squeeze to remove the pulp, and you can discard this residue of the ingredients and repeat this process until done. To remove the fine particles, I am straining it again. However, you can also use muslin cloth to strain. Here's a small tip. Instead of discarding this pulp, you can make use of it to the most. Add it to a mixer grinder and grind it to a smooth paste and use it as a hair mask. Leave it on your hair for at least 30 minutes and then shampoo your hair. As you can see, the shampoo has beautiful natural lather without adding chemicals. You can store this shampoo in a repurposed bottle for a week. But if you want to store it for months, make it in large batch like this. What I usually do is, I take these kinds of cups, or you can use any molds also, fill the shampoo and freeze it. Once they are frozen, demold them and you can put them in a zipper pouch like this and keep it in the freezer. You can store them up to 6 months. Isn't that cool? To use this shampoo, before you wash your hair, take 1 or 2 blocks out of freezer and keep it out for some time. When it comes to room temperature, you can shampoo your hair. If you are a busy person, this way you can save a lot of time and you won't end up doing this long procedure every week. This shampoo cleanses your hair beautifully. Use this shampoo at least once a week. But if you have heavily oiled your hair, this shampoo will remove the oil to an extent as it is very mild. You may have to use more quantity of shampoo than the store-bought one. One thing to note is, after hair wash, you may find some residue stuck on your hair. You don't have to panic. As you dry your hair and comb it, it will come out. This homemade shampoo is completely safe for all hair types. You can get gorgeous hair that glows with good health always. Do give this shampoo a try, and if you have used this shampoo, please comment and share your experience and result. I would love to hear from you. I hope you found this video helpful. Do like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day.